Here is the wine rack that I purchased from a seller off of Craigslist about a year ago. I purchased this wine rack for $20. I brought it home, I cleaned it up, and then I placed a bunch of my Goodwill finds on it and placed it in my kitchen. I've removed all of the items from this wine rack so that I can begin and start the process of the upcycle and facelift of this wine rack. Here is the Rust-Oleum spray paint that I've chose to use for the upcycle and facelift of this wine rack. I chose the color bright gold. Here I've taken some old newspaper and covered up the area that I do not wish to spray paint. And next I'll be taking this outside and going ahead and applying the gold metallic spray paint. Here you can see where I have taken the wine rack outside and I have started the process of spray painting this wine rack. The only error that I made was not placing down some newspaper prior to spray painting the rack. But it's okay. I think it's turning out pretty good so far. Do you guys remember these from the original photo of the wine rack? Well, I have a little bit of spray paint left over, and I just want to jazz these up just a little bit. So that remaining spray paint, I'm going to use it to spray paint the corks. Remember this? This was on the original wine rack. I purchased this from Dollar Tree. I'm giving this a new look as well. Here is all the glassware that I went out thrifting and purchased for the wine rack. I had these glass previously. I purchased them for $1, but because the tag of the week that was 50% off was red, I went ahead and picked up two additional ones for 50 cents a piece. These were featured in a tablescape a couple weeks ago. I also picked up these, and I thought these were really nice. And they were $1 each, so I purchased two. I think the gold will look nice. Now I absolutely love, love, love these wine glasses right here. I have a decanter that I think this will go perfectly with. There were only three available, and they were $1 a piece. So of course I bought those home, and then I picked up three more. These were red tags, so these were only 50 cents a piece because the original price of them were $1. So I paid 50 cents for these, and I can't wait to clean these up and get everything situated on the wine rack. While thrifting, I also picked up these four nice mirrors that were originally from IKEA, and I purchased them for $1 a piece. I want to use these on the top of the wine rack as well as the bottom. The top of the wine rack has a rattan top, so I want to create a flat surface, as well as the bottom, it has slats. So I want to use it. See here, look right there at the bottom. You see that? I want to place those mirrors there to prevent anything from falling through. So here is the final reveal. Here you can see that I've already started to style the wine rack. This is the beautiful decanter that I was speaking in reference of earlier that I thought was a perfect match for those wine glasses, and I have that graced on top of the IKEA mirror. I've also placed two on the bottom, as well as that Dollar Tree font that I spray painted. I think everything is coming together really nice. I'm going to go ahead and finish styling the wine rack, and I'll come back and show you the finished look. Here is the wine rack completely styled, and I think that it turned out beautiful. I've added the additional decanter, the other wine glasses, the existing bottles of wine and sparkling water, as well as these glitter gold balls that I picked up from Pier 1. I also added those golden paperweights at the bottom, and you can see the additional glassware that is staged at the bottom of the wine rack. And of course, I had to add a little touch of fall with the pumpkin. I love that decanter there.